हेलो, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द कन्वेंशनल एंड द मॉडर्न कोमबर प्रिपरेटरी. सो लेट अस सी द कन्वेंशनल कोमबर प्रिपरेटरी फर्स्ट. एंड द फर्स्ट मशीन दैट कम्स इन द कोमबर प्रिपरेटरी इज अ स्लाइवर लैप मशीन. द स्लाइवर लैप मशीन इज द फर्स्ट मशीन इन द सीक्वेंस ऑफ कन्वेंशनल कोमबर लैप प्रिपरेशन. यूजली 24 स्लाइवर्स आर फेड टुगेदर साइड बाई साइड ओवर अ फीड टेबल टू द ड्राफ्टिंग अरेंजमेंट. A web is formed with a small draft of up to 1.5 to 2, and this web is rolled into a lap by the calendar rollers. So let us see a video of this sliver lap machine.
Carded sliver needs to be prepared in the form of a narrow lap before the combing process. 15 to 24 carded slivers are drawn over a feeding table into a drafting and pressing system and wound onto a bobbin. The full bobbin is ejected out to the bobbin creel when it reaches the predetermined length. Owing to the mixing and doubling of a number of slivers, blending and parallelization of the fibers are improved.
Okay, so let us look at the technical data of a sliver lap machine. Doubling is 24, total draft 1.323, lap width is 250 mm, lap weight is around 25 kgs, delivery speed 80 to 100 meters per minute, and production around 480 kgs per hour. So with this, let us come to the next machine in the conventional Kombar lap preparation, and that's the ribbon lap machine. Here, 6 laps from the sliver lap machine are fed individually to separate drafting systems. The 6 webs that are formed after drafting are passed over a deflecting plate at an angle of 90 degrees almost and are collected one on top of the other on a collecting table. These overlapping webs are pressed by calendar rollers to form a compact web and are then rolled into a lap on a set of lap rollers. So here's a video of the ribbon lap machine.
There are 6 identical heads on a ribbon lap machine. Sliver laps located at the back of the machine are drawn through a drafting system similar to that of a draw frame. Each of the sliver laps is individually drafted and the fibers inside are straightened to form 6 webs. These webs are then joined together and wound onto a coma bobbin. The coma bobbin is ejected out into the bobbin creel when it reaches the predetermined length. In comparison with a sliver lap, the draft of a ribbon lap is much higher, so that further mixing and blending of fibers inside the lap can be achieved.
So we come to the technical data on ribbon lap machine. Doublings are 6. Total draft is 3.5 to 8. Lap width is 300 mm. Lap weight is around 20 kgs. Delivery speed is around 85 to 100 meters per minute. And production is around 480 kgs per hour. So with this, let us have a look at the modern Kombar preparatory. In the modern Kombar preparatory, it is attempted to produce the lap in one single process. So the lap former will follow the normal draw frame passage after card. The lap forming machine by Ritter is a unilap machine. 12 cans each are fed from two sides of the machine, giving a total number of 24 doublings. The slivers are guided by the sliver guide rollers to the two drafting systems, and the drafting systems are 3/3 system, which has got a 2-zone drafting. So this is the sketch of a unilap, where you can see the slivers, there will be similar cans all placed over here in the creel, and you will see that the slivers will just pass over, and these are the two drafting systems that we can see, which are inclined over here. And after the sheet web comes out, it is passed on to this table and then it goes through a set of calendar rollers over here, and set of 4 calendar rollers rather, and then it is wound onto a bobbin or a tube and you get a lap. So this is the actual image of such a unilap. You can see the slivers are being fed here, and these are coming from a draw frame, which is before the unilap. The webs produced are passed over the deflecting plates on the web table, as we have just seen, where the webs are superimposed and run through 4 calendar rulers. This is the drafting system. It's a 3/3 drafting system. And here we can see this drafting system. There are two of them, as we've seen earlier, and all these slivers in a form of a network or a web just enter these two drafting systems, and after the web is formed, they are passed through the calendar rulers for compaction, and then they form a lamp. So the calendar rulers help in compacting the webs by the application of pressure. After calendaring, the web is wound on the bobbin or the tube to form the lamp. So the lap winding system on Unilab, the calendar rollers are followed by two winding rollers. After the calendar rollers, that is, there are four calendar rollers, there are two winding rollers which are marked as two over here, and a lap or a bobbin or a tube holding device, which is three. This is a holding device. And the pressure is applied by a piston. This is the piston, and the pressure goes on increasing as the lap diameter increases. The machine stops when the preset lap length is reached, and a full lap is replaced by an empty tube automatically. So there was some kind of improvement over the earlier system that we have just seen in case of winding, which was called as Omega Lap Winding. The new system of lap winding developed by Ritter has an advantage of increased production over the earlier winding system, which used calendar rollers. So in this, the Omega Lap system uses the belt tension and pressure arrangement. The width of the winding belt is similar to the lap width, and it surrounds the lap to apply a circumferential pressure in the form of a shape of an omega, and therefore it is called as omega winding. And this particular circumference that it covers would be from ranging from 180 degrees to 270 degrees, which is 180 at the start, and at when the lap is complete, it is almost 270 degrees it covers or it surrounds. And this is how it looks. You can see the lap is almost getting filled up, and you have a 270 degrees lap circumference. And this is the belt system that helps forming this kind of a uniform lap. So the Omega Lap system allows for a constant production level with higher speeds, up to 180 meters per minute over the entire lap buildup, due to the better fiber guidance and pressure distribution that this particular system provides. So we come to the video of the Omega Lap, and let us just look at it. As you can see, one Omega Lap would feed around 6 combers. You can see the Omega Lap E36 machine. You can see the slivers entering the two drafting systems shown over here, and the web is coming out on the table. This is the internal mechanism, how the lap is formed. Once the lap is formed, it is automatically ejected on the table. So with this, we look at the technical data of Unilab machine. Doublings are 28, total draft around 1.3 to 2.2, lap width 300 mm, lap weight around 25 kgs, The delivery speed in case of Unilab is varying. It is 70 to 140 meters per minute. With Omega Lab, however, we can have a constant speed up to 180 meters per minute throughout. So this was the situation in case of the earlier Unilab system of working or production. So as you can see, earlier it was like it had a constant speed around 70 meters per minute throughout the buildup. This is the lap length on the x-axis. As the lap length increases, there is no change. There's a constant speed of Unilab, which is around 70. But there was an improvement over this where a video speed was system was applied over here. So what you can see is the winding speed would increase in the beginning, and as it becomes critical later on during almost the end of the winding, the speeds would reduce. So this would help in increase in production, which is shaded over here with blue. This is the increase in production due to the increase in speed over here in the beginning. So it would lead to higher production levels. But as against this, we have this Omega Lab, which is still better, and you can achieve a constant speed of 180 meters per minute due to better fiber guidance and uniform distribution of pressure in case of Omega Lab. So production in the earlier Unilab was 350 kgs per hour, whereas with Omega Lab it is 520 kgs per hour. So now we come to the part where we see the problem related with the Comber preparatory, and one of the problems is lap leaking. The layer of the lap sheet when during opening on Comber, if a lap sheet sticks to the earlier lap sheet during unwinding, it is it leads to unevenness and disturbances in the Comber, and this particular defect is called as lap leaking. If the fibers are highly parallelized, it creates a smooth lap surface leading to lap leaking. So this is a result of highly parallelized fibers, which is again a result of high draft. Therefore, low drafts are maintained during lap preparation to avoid this kind of a lap leaking problem. So with this, we come to the end of the lecture. Thank you.